Ohio's Stephanie Bronze found herself feeling ill, day in, day out, for 6 long months, beginning in late 2016. Eventually, the 53-year-old realized that the onset of her sickness bouts seemed to coincide with the first coffee of the day. So the resourceful woman opened her coffee maker up, and what she found inside gave her grievous grounds for complaint. For many caffeine fans, starting the day without a cup of coffee is simply unimaginable. And it was the same for Bronze, who lives in Withamsville, outside Cincinnati in Ohio. However, towards the end of 2016, the human resources manager began experiencing worrying symptoms every morning after her habitual cup of joe. Apparently, Bronze had owned her trusty coffee maker for years and relied on it to fix her a brew before she left for work each day. She has not reported any previous problems with the machine. So her sudden instances of illness following her morning drink percolated no little confusion. Indeed, Bronze said as much in an interview with ABC-affiliated Cincinnati TV station WPCO in March 2017. "I always had my coffee at home," she explained. "And within 3 sips. Having severe reactions." Regardless, she carried on drinking her daily dose. In fact, Bronze persisted with her morning perk until a friend alerted her to an online article. The report in question highlighted the dangers of coffee makers, and the dirt that they can collect and conceal. As a result, Bronze decided to open hers up and see what lurked within. Consequently, perhaps because she was a busy woman and did not want to waste time at home, Bronze brought her coffee machine to work. When the time was right, the coffee lover prized open the top of the appliance using a screwdriver right there in the office. And the grime she found inside completely grossed her out. The internet piece Bronze had read warned coffee fans that their machines could be harboring a range of bacteria and mold. A 2011 study by Health and Safety Product Testers NSF International concluded that traditional carafe-style coffee makers can often have higher germ counts than toilet seats. In 2014, germ expert Kelly Reynolds, associate professor of public health at the University of Arizona, spoke to the Huffington Post about the study. "Coffee makers are certainly a moist environment where mold and bacteria are known to grow in high number," she confirmed. "Our bodies can deal with them, but at some point they'll grow to levels high enough to cause sickness." And sure enough, when Braun cracked open her machine, she could not believe the high levels of calcium buildup, never mind the brownish mold-like substance that had collected over the years. "It was horrifying," Bronze told WCPO. "Horrifying, is what was my reaction." What made the sickened woman even more baffled was the fact that the inside of her coffee maker was so hard to access and clean. As a result, Bronze was not sure what she could have done in order to prevent such a disgusting buildup, or how she could do now to remove it. Bronze discussed her dilemma in the WCPO segment. "It is impossible to get to the full tank, unless you dismantle this machine, which I haven't figured out yet," she explained. "Outside of taking a hammer to it, I don't know how to completely open it and see what's inside." Following her dread discovery, Bronze was keen to warn other coffee maker owners about the dangers dwelling deep in their devices. And she wanted to make sure coffee geeks no longer turned a blind eye to hidden horrors inside their gadgets. "You need to be able to clean that area," Bronze insisted. "With this in mind, it is important that everyone with a coffee machine knows exactly how to clean it." Most manufacturers include wash instructions in user manuals for these appliances. However, to make sure everyone was crystal clear, Caroline Forte from the Good Housekeeping Research Institute had some expert advice in 2014. As quoted in the Huffington Post article, the director of the UK magazine's Home Appliances and Cleaning Products Lab, said that vinegar was the secret weapon here. And it was due to the fact that the Wonder product not only sanitizes but also has the ability to decalcify. For those with classic coffee makers, Forte went on to recommend gentle daily cleaning and a deeper occasional cleanse. The carafe, lid and filter baskets should be cleaned daily with warm, sudsy water, she explained. A coffee maker that's used daily should be decalcified about once per month in hard water areas and every 2 to 3 months in soft water areas. And Forte added that pod coffee makers should be tackled in a similar way. While these gadgets may be more advanced than their carafe-based counterparts, they can still fall victim to calcium buildups. As a result, pod devotees should run vinegar through their devices about 4 times a year. But not only will cleaning a coffee maker regularly yield a better tasting brew, the simple task can also protect a coffee lover's health. Bronze sent samples of the crud she found in her machine off to a lab to be tested. However, in the NSF International study, 1 in 10 appliances were found to contain coliform bacteria. Nonetheless, these germs do not usually cause illnesses in fit and healthy people. But they are often found alongside other more dangerous pathogens. These potentially sickness-causing microorganisms include bacteria, viruses, and a number of multicellular parasites. Moreover, their presence can also indicate fecal contamination. However, after news of Braun's sickening experience broke online, seasoned coffee maker users were happy to report that vinegar cleaned up. "We use the vinegar trick all the time with ours. Also clean the coffee pot after every use," one YouTube user wrote when the WCPO clip was uploaded to the video sharing. "Too much coffee can be bad for your health," they say, but few expected the humble coffee maker to be dangerous. Nevertheless, while technology has made it easy to achieve the perfect brew, but also easy to make the user feel perfectly awful, there is an answer. To ensure that all your coffee maker gives you is a spring in your step, regular cleaning is key. And remember, vinegar is your friend.